All right, welcome back, guys. So this very short video is a quick review over Chapter 7, Dilations. Remember, dilations are a non-rigid transformation. That means the shape of the image and the pre-image are not the same size. So therefore, it's a non-rigid transformation. When we're asked to find in this first problem, what's the scale factor? What do we have to multiply the length of one side of a triangle to get the length of a second side of a triangle? And remember, the order in which we're going to dilate matters. So please notice, we're told figure A is the pre-image, figure B is the image. So we need to go from this side here to this side there. Now I chose these because they're horizontal. It's going to be really easy to count what is the length of this side. So noticing this counts by 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. The total length of this side is 6 units. So 6 on figure A, this corresponding side on figure B is 1 and 1, so it's 2 units. So what do we have to do to go from 6 units to 2 units? Well, mathematically, because we're talking about factors, this is either multiply or this is divide. Multiply or divide. What do I have to do mathematically to go from 6 to 2? Well, to do that, we're going to divide by 3. Right? Now, let's remember scale factor. The notation we use for scale factor is K. Now, if I put 3 here, that would mean I multiply by 3. And we don't write divide by 3. We're going to say 1/3 because that fraction means divide. So our scale factor to go from figure A to figure B is a scale factor of 1/3. Now, when we look at problem number 2, we're told A is at 3, 4, R is at 9, 12. Find K, find the scale factor if the pre-image is A and the image is R, okay? So again, the order in which we're gonna move from one figure to another does matter, okay? So if we look at A is 3 to 4, R is 9 and 12, okay? Let me actually, I found these really cool pens. They erase, okay? I'm gonna spread this out just a little bit. R is 9, 12. Okay, mathematically, what do we need to do to go from 3 to 9? Mathematically, what do we need to go from 4 to 12? In each case, the x coordinates you would multiply by 3, the y coordinates you would multiply by 3. So our scale factor, since both x and y coordinates are multiplied by 3, the scale factor is 3. All right, so now let's start graphing. Here we're asked to draw a dilation with a scale factor of 2. Now remember, if we're not told where's the center of dilation, if we're not told, then the center of dilation is at the origin. It is at 0, 0. Okay, so with that in mind, because it wasn't told to us, we do make a safe assumption. We're going to center everything right there in the middle. So in order to do this, I need to know what are the coordinates. If A is located at 1, 1, B is located at 2, negative 1, and C is located at negative 2, 0. then that scale factor of 2 means I'm going to take each x and each y, and I'm going to multiply them by 2. So then that means, and I'm a little off-center here, I apologize, that means that a prime will be located at 2, 2. B prime would be located at 4, negative 2. And C prime would be located at negative 4 and 0. Now, because I've just drawn all over the place, I'm going to use a highlighter to plot these points next, or to draw the figure. So A prime is at 2, 2. B prime is at 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 2. And C prime is at negative 4 and 0. And so this figure, if I don't mess it up, this figure here is the enlargement of triangle ABC. All right, our last problem deals with figures. I'm given sides. I need to know what's the scale factor. Now, we've kind of already done this in numbers 1 and 2, but looking at what are those scale factors when I go from A to B or B to A. So very similarly, I need to look at some corresponding sides to figure out what that math is going to look like. So let me zoom in real quick. All right. So if we know that the figures are similar, then that means that corresponding sides here and here are going to have the same ratio as, and I should have gotten another marker out. So let me do that. Here and here. Okay, those sides have to have the same ratios when the figures are similar. So if the problem was written a little differently and I needed to know what are the values of x, y, and z, I would double check a set of sides that I'm given and then use that ratio to find what's missing. In this case, let's just find the scale factor. My pink sides here, 2 and 6, the order I put them in matters. So when we're going from figure A to figure B, that means we have to go from a side length of 6 to a side length of 2. Again, mathematically, the only way to do that is to divide 6 by 3. So the scale factor from A to B is going to be 1/3. But if I switch that order and I'm going from figure B to figure A, then that means a side length of 2 has to become a side length of 6. And so mathematically, the only way to do that is to multiply 2 times 3 to get 6. So here the scale factor is a positive 3. All right, so that is the end of this video. You guys go tackle those practice problems, and the answer key should be on the website very soon.